My name is Vagan Mushegyan. I am I guess now a seventh year DDS PhD student at UCSF in the School of Dentistry and the Craniofacial and Mesenchymal Biology program. So I'm a dentist by clinical training, and my research involves understanding the mechanisms of evolution and development of stem cell niches.
So we're looking at seeing whether in between here there is a presence of the receptor. So we're going to switch to a different light.
Initially, when I was about five, I got asked what I wanted to do, and I said I want to be a dentist without really knowing what it's what you know the word means, and it kind of sort of stuck with me through the years. And my parents are engineers, and my grandmother, actually, who raised me a lot in addition to my parents, because they were both professionals working, was a chemist. So a lot of my, you know, after school, before my parents got home, upbringing was through her. And we did a lot of stuff like, you know, going outdoors and going to parks and exploring nature and kind of having talks about how does biology work, how does chemistry work, and, you know, that's how it was my first introduction to really the sciences. Most of the young kids' questions of why and how tend to be answered in a very abstract way, whereas she would literally explain to a 4 or 5 year old how molecules worked and how, you know, why do you have vapor versus water versus, you know, ice. So having a very concrete understanding of some of the very basic things from early on got me started on the path of wanting to learn more. So I am in a developmental and evolutionary lab at UCSF. The problems that we address in the Klein Lab are ranging from understanding how do certain molecules in teeth come together to form a tooth in development, and also understanding how certain clinical problems can be addressed genetically. So there's a lot of genetic defects in patients which have craniofacial anomalies, stemming from cleft lip and palate to more of a classical genetic issues, such as Pierre-Benson syndrome, things of that nature. So what we try to do in the lab on a day-to-day basis is try to use molecular techniques available in the lab to elucidate how the development in regular scenarios works and what happens in development when we have a clinical issue. So trying to understand the mechanical and the molecular issues associated with craniofacial anomalies. So specifically, my project deals with understanding the development of teeth. So we have many defects in patients which result in either lack of teeth or decreased number of teeth. In addition, in patients who do not have any genetic disorders, throughout life, people lose their teeth due to trauma, due to caries. That's why dentists exist as a profession. So one of the ways that we are trying to address this issue is trying to find a way to regenerate teeth. Or, you know, in the best world scenario, what my project outcome would be is finding a way to grow new teeth and then essentially give those two new teeth to patients. So using patient cells to convert patient cells potentially to cells which then we can use in the lab to grow up a tooth or a part of a tooth, implant it back to the patient, and then have that patient have a new tooth instead of having an implant or a bridge or things of that nature. Yeah, I think in any profession, there is an innate kind of desire to do it. I have an academic question which I'm trying to address, and, you know, knowing that I'm getting a step closer to achieving that goal is just as interesting as, you know, trying to figure out what is it going to be once that goal is achieved. The other thing is, as a doctor, as a clinician, on a day-to-day basis, I see patients who remind me why I'm doing what I'm doing in the lab, and that is a very strong motivator. When you see, you know, a young kid with a disorder that does not allow him to have teeth, and that puts a tremendous social impact, tremendous clinical impact on him, and knowing that I can do something to, in the future, ameliorate his situation is a huge motivator. If you work hard, you'll make it. I think one of the things that would make it easy for me in my process is knowing that if I'm doing everything I'm supposed to do, it will all work out. So if you put yourself in a position where you are on top of your grades, you find mentors, even if you don't have mentors within your family, within your peers, reach out for them. So, you know, in combination, work hard, set your goals and keep your goals where they are, keep them straight, don't change your goals to something easier if things get tough. They're supposed to get tough. That's why this isn't an easy profession to get into. And find a good mentor. A good mentor is worth their weight in gold.